ஏனாஞ்சனம் அலீமசா அச்சுதாய நமஸ்தஸ்மை பரமௌசித்ய காரிணே. ஸோ வி வர் லுக்கிங் அட் தி ஒன் ஸோ வி லுக்ட் அட் தி வாட் இஸ் தி ஔச்சித்ய ஸ்வரூபம் வேர் தி டிஃபரன்ஸ் இன் உச்சிதஸ்தான விநியாசாது அலங்கிருதிஹி அலங்கிருதிஹி ஔச்சித்யாது அச்சுதா ஔச்சித்யாது அச்சுதாக நித்யம் பவந்தி ஏவ குணா குணாக டில் தட் ஸ்லோக அண்ட் தென் ஆஃப்டர் தட் கண்டே மேகலையா ஹவு த டிஃபரெண்ட் திங்ஸ் வேர் இஃப் சம் ஒன் இஸ் சரண்டரிங் அண்ட் ஹி ஷோஸ் வீரம் டுவர்ட்ஸ் தட் பர்சன் தென் இட் டசன்ட் இட் இஸ் நாட் காங்க்ருவென்ட் அண்ட் ஸோ ஔச்சித்யம் இஸ் நாட் தேர் அண்ட் இன் த சேம் வே அட் எவ்ரி பாயிண்ட் யூ நீட் ஔச்சித்யம் ரைட் ஃப்ரம் பத டு ரசா இஃப் யூ லுக் அட் த காவிய ஷரீரம் ரைட் ஃப்ரம் சப்தார்த்த and then gunam riti vritti everything needs to have the auchityam there including rasa bhava bhava bhasa and everything now he comes to the auchitya lakshanam according to kshemendra he says uchitam prahuhu acharyaha sadrisham kila yasya yat uchitasya cha yo bhavah tad auchityam prachakshate now this is the definition that he gives What does it mean? Yasya yat kila sadrisham tat uchitam iti acharyaha prahu. Yasya yat sadrisham. That which is equal to. Sadrisham is not just upamana upameya sadrisham that he is talking about. Sadrisham is not just similarity or anything. It's more the appropriateness that we look at. If this can go along with that. Samana darshanam or when we look at it it seems like this can only go with this right with certain people we say you know they're a match well matched pair like that so that is your sadrisha here so yasya yat kila sadrisham that which is samanam that which can be equal to another is termed as uchita by acharyas and uchitasya yaha bhavah so the attitude or the quality of being sadrisha is auchityam tasya bhavah auchityam iti prachakshate the vritti for this is yatkila yasya anurupam tat uchitam uchyate tasya bhavam auchityam kathayanti he writes his own vritti for his shloka so it's the same anurupam that's what I said it is not sadrisham it is not equal it is not similar or anything anurupam rupam அனுகம்ய வர்த்ததே இட் ஃபாலோஸ் தட் அண்ட் ஸ்டேஸ் லைக் தட் ஓகே இஃப் ஐ லுக் இட் சம்வன் அண்ட் சே யூ நோ ஹீ இஸ் லைக் சிவா இட் டசன்ட் மீன் தட் ஹீ ஹாஸ் ஃபோர் ஹேண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் ஹீ ஹாஸ் ஓன்லி கஜசர்மா ஆன் ஹிஸ் இது அண்ட் ஹீ ஹாஸ் ஸ்னேக்ஸ் ஆன் ஹிஸ் கண்டா அண்ட் ஆல் தட் சம் குவாலிட்டிஸ் யூ ஆர் அசோசியேட்டிங் வித் தட் பர்சன் அண்ட் யூ ஆர் சேயிங் தட் திஸ் பர்சன் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு தட் பர்சன் இன் சர்டன் வேஸ் தட் இஸ் யுவர் அனுரூபம் தத் உச்சிதம் தட் இஸ் த மீனிங் ஆஃப் உச்சித அண்ட் உச்சிதஸ்ய பாவ இஸ் ஔச்சித்யம் நவ் ஹீ கோஸ் டு த ஸ்பெசிஃபிக் different things that are there in the Auchityam, where he says, Adhuna sakala kavya shastra jivatubhutasya pradhanyena upalabhyam sthitim darshayitum aha. This is there in the Vyakhyanam. This is not in the text. The text has only these shlokas. Now, what does that mean? Kavya sharira jivatubhutasya auchityasya. Everywhere we will keep reading Kavya Sharira Jivatu Bhuta or Atma Bhutasya Rasasya. It's very natural if I make that mistake. Please take it as only Auchityam because in this text we are reading about Auchityam. So for a Kavya Shariram, the soul is Auchitya. And Pradhanyena, wherever it is available, where it is available or where you can find that Auchitya is, பதே வாக்கியே பிரபந்தார்த்தே குணே அலங்கரணே ரசே கிரியாயாம் காரகே லிங்கே வச்சனே ச விசேஷணே உபசர்கே நிபாதே ச காலே தேசே குலே விரதே தத்வே சத்வேபி அபிப்ராயே ஸ்வபாவே சாரசங்கிரஹே பிரதிபாயாம் அவஸ்தாயாம் விசாரே நாம்னி அத ஆசிஷி காவியஸ்ய அங்கேஷு ச பிராஹுஹு ஔசித்யம் வியாபி ஜீவிதம் காவியஸ்ய அங்கேஷு வியாபி ஜீவிதம் ச ஔசித்யம் இதி பிராஹு காவியஸ்ய ஏதேஷு அங்கேஷு வாட் ஆர் ஆல் த டிஃபரெண்ட் அங்கஸ் ஆஃப் அ காவிய த டிஃபரெண்ட் பார்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் அ காவிய ஆர் பத வாக்கிய பிரபந்தார்த்த ஈச் ஒன் ஐ வில் டிஃபைன் நவ் in all these angas, in all these parts of a kavya, auchityam has to be vyapi. Vyapi means vyapnoti. It should pervade these angas, all of these angas. You can't just have, see, pada auchityam is there, but rasa auchityam is not there. That is not going to work. And every, imagine the work of a kavi here. He has to put in so much of effort to give that beauty in every aspect of kavya. Kavyasya angeshu vyapi tadeva jivitam iti prahuhu. Just like in our angas, in our body, you can't pinpoint and say my jivitam or the soul, atma, is there in this part. It is there in this part or it is there in this part. You can't pinpoint and say it is vyaptam. Sarveshu angeshu vyaptam yatu atma athava jivitam tadeva. Pranam keeps going everywhere, right? Think of it as prana. If the pranam is not there, there is no point of the atma being in the shariram itself. So this pranam is something that connects everything together. Yes, the atma is there, but the pranam or the vayu, the breath of life that we have is the thing that connects every anga to that atma and the shariram and everything. So this auchityam is like the jivitam or the pranam, which is vyapi, which is all pervasive in the angas of a kavyam or the kavya shariram. Okay, now what is each of these part we talked about in the introduction about how the first three are Mimamsa Pradhana, then you have the Alankara Shastra, Sahitya Shastra Pradhana, then the Vyakarana Shastra Pradhanam, Loka Pradhanam, Loka Tantram, and Kavitantram. Here the Pada, Vakya, and Prabandha are based on Mimamsa Tantra. Padam ityukte sukting antam padam. We have to go not just because it is Mimamsa, you can only look at Mimamsa's definition. For everything, Pradamohi Vidvamsaha Vidyakaranaha. Their start for everything, the first scholars in the world are the grammarians, because they only talk about the analysis of word and anything, communication, right? So padam, they say, is sup ting antam padam. Subantam tingantam cha padasamnyam syat. What is subantam? You have su aujas am aukshas. Tabhyambhyas, yebhyambhyas, nasibhyambhyas, nasosam, niyosup. These are the pratyas that are added to the pratipatika or a root word. If you look at the Shabdamanjari, you will have akarantav pullingaha rama shabdaha. Rama is your pratipatika or root word. Behind that, you will add pratyayas like su, au, jas and all these to form your that table, like the multiplication table. You have your shabdas. Ramaha, Ramau, Ramaha, Ramam, Ramau, Ram. So even in those Karaka and everything, you will find Pratyaya, Upasarga, everywhere you need the Auchityam. That he will talk about in the next section after the Rasam. But here he only talks about one Pada. It can either be your noun, which is Subanta, or it can be Tingantam. Don't please take the word noun, when I say noun, it does not mean this. So let me use just Subanta. The English noun cannot be a synonym for Subanta. Then Tinganta is those words which have Ting at their end. You have Tiptas, Jing, Siptastha, Mipvasmas, and those are the Pratyayas that join with the Dhatu to make Kriyapadas. So subantam tingantam cha padasamyam syat. So pade auchityam. Next is vakye. Pada samuhaha vakyam. Many words are joined together to give a meaningful. So vakyam is based on akanksha, yogyata and sannidhi. These are the three things that are very important for a set of words to be called a vakyam. When does it become a vakya? Not just Purushaha, Hasti, Gajaha, Ashvaha. I have a Pada Samuham. Pada Samavayam is needed. So here it is not just a group of words. They have to connect to each other. So there is an expectation. So I can't just say Ashvaha. That is a sentence. No, it's not. It expects something. Ashvaha, Kaha, Athava, Kim Karoti, Something or the other it expects. So that is the akanksha. So there is an expectation of one word with another word, and that should be satisfied in that sentence. Then only that pada samoha, that set of words is called a vakya. What is yogyata? I can't say agnina sinchati. This is the famous example that they will say, where I sprinkle with fire. Is there, does it sound correct? Is there a compatibility between the two words? You cannot sprinkle with agni. So jalena sinchati will work, agnina sinchati will not work. So there should be a yogyata between the padas. Next is sannidhi. I will say Lakshmi today, and then tomorrow I will say patha. Will those two get connected? No. Or if I say after 2 hours also, it is not going to connect. So they have to be together. That is your sannidhi. So you need akanksha, yogyata and sannidhi for a set of words to become vakya. Tadrisha vakye api auchityam bhavitavya. Next, prabandharthe. Prabandhartha, prabandhasya raghuvamshadi rupasya arthe pratipadya vishaye. What is the subject matter that you are taking up? There should be some relevant subject matter, one thing, or it should at least be I don't know whether a big Mahakavyam on table can even work. So the Prabandhartha is very important. What is the subject matter of the Prabandha, the work that you are talking about? Prabandha is the Kavyam, not only Kavyam, but Natakam and everything. So Raghuvamshadi Rupasya Prabandhasya Granthasya Arthe Pratipadya Vishaye. The Vishaya, the subject matter that you are trying to convey, Pratipadya Vishaye, that should also have an auchityam there. What is your text title? What is the Vishayam that you are trying to say? There should be a congruity there, right? Gune. Guna is your, the 24 gunas according to Prataparudra or Prataparudra Kara Vidyanatha, or you can talk about just the 4 or 5 gunas that Kavya Prakasha says, or many people for that matter. So they all, Pamadurya, Moj of Prasada, that's all they will say, whereas our Vidyanatha will talk about Slesh of Prasada Samatha and he starts off. So these are all technical terms in Alankara Shastra. We are done with Mimamsa Shastra, where it is Pada, Vakya and Prabandha. Here it is Guna, Alankarana and Rasa. Gunam is Ojav Prasadadi Rupe Gune Auchityam. Alankarane Anuprasa Upama. Everywhere, I repeat once more, Anuprasa is Shabda Alankara, Upama is Artha Alankara. So Anuprasa Upamadi Rupe Api Auchityam. Rase. Rasa is Karuna Shantadi. Usually everybody says Shungaradi. Here he, in the Vyakhyana, he points out very differently and says Karuna Shantadi. Rupe Rase. Rasam does not just mean Rasa. That is the Navarasas. It includes 8 things in it. Why? Because the vyutpatti of the word Rasa itself is Rasyate Aswadyate Iti Rasaha. It has the capability, or it is being enjoyed. It has the capability of being enjoyed. Aswadana yogyata vartate iti rasaha. So aswadana yogyata na kevalam rase vartate, bhavana bhaveshu api vartate. What are those? Those are vyabhichari bhavas. You have the rasa bhava, then rasa abhasa bhava abhasa. Rasavat ye abhasante te rasa abhasaha. For example, when you know, Ravana feels love towards Sita, it is called Rasabhasa because Ravana is not the Nayaka, he is the Pratinayaka. Even though Sita is the Nayaka, Sita can be the Alambana Vibhava for Ravana's Shrungara. But it is not Shrungara per se, it is Shrungara Abhasa. It is not the permanent beautiful sentiment of love where it is being reciprocated. If it is not being reciprocated, then it is not the love sentiment there. Right? So rasa bhava, the same goes for bhava bhasa. Then bhava udaya for example, kopa or manam or kampaha. Someone is looking at Parashurama and feeling fear, and he is describing the shloka in such a way that you also are trembling. Then the bhava that arises there is bhava udaya. That sentiment also you can understand. That is bhava udaya. Bhava sandhi, bhava shanti. Bhava shanti is the, suppose the nayika is angry, nayika comes and says some santvana vakyam. He says, you know, don't be so angry or something like that. And then you realize that that kopam is gone. That is bhava shanti. Then bhava sandhi is the two bhavas coming together in one shloka. Either, for example, the kopam and prasadaha, both can come together in one shloka. And then bhava shabalata, bhava sandhi, bhavodaya, bhava shabalata. I'm missing out one, no? Rasa, bhava, bhavabhasa, rasabhasa, bhavodaya, bhava shanti, bhava sandhi, and bhava shabalata. Correct. Bhava shabalata is a mixture of many different bhavas, can also happen in a shloka. So it takes time to recognize these shlokas and identify whether it is bhavodaya, bhava shanti, or bhava shabalata, or even shrungara rasa, rasa purvakam. All these, it will take time. So all of these are within that sixth category of rase. So rasyate, aswadyate, all these can also be fit to be enjoyed, and hence all of these come under the category of rase. Karuna shantadi rupe rase. Next is vyakarana section. We come to it. That is kriyayam. Now what is that? You might ask, what is the difference between pade and kriya? There is, in the sense, it is just whether you have used this particular verb or not, whether this verb has to be used or not is different from what is the context there and which type of verb he has used. For he can, instead of, you know, hanti tadayati, there is a big difference in kriya. Hanti means killing. It can also be used as for hitting, whereas tadayati is only hitting. You can't say mata putram tadayati is okay, but mata putram hanti will not be okay. That is kriya. That is not in pada auchityam. Pada auchityam is just the fact that she is hitting her itself is a problem there. Right? A mother who is so loving will never think of hitting, right? That is in the pada auchityam. Whereas in the kriya auchityam, whether this is the word that I need to use or not, there are 20 different verbs for gachati. Even hanti means gachati. Whether I can use that word or not is a problem here. So that is kriyayam. Next is karake, kartra karmadi rupe. Karaka, you have different karakas like karta, karma, karana, sampradana, apadana. At this point, can I use this or not? If I say matuhu smarati and mataram smarati, there is a big difference between that. I like to take that example always. Now, someone who remembers his mother, mataram smarati, is just, okay, I remember my mom. If you say matuhu smarati, matuhu is shashti vibhakti. There the karaka is shashti sheshe. If you use, he not only remembers just her physical form or her appearance or anything, she remembers all the gunas that are associated with the mata. How loving she was, or how endearing she was to me, how helpful she was, how she was like a teacher. You know, there are so many qualities that you associate with your mother, and all those qualities are understood by the usage of the Shashti Vibhakti. Karake api auchityam vartate. Linge stri pumadi rupe. Of course, linga samyam and vachana samyam and all is like, in Upama Alankara, you will find this. The appropriateness of using the gender is very, very important in Upama Alankara, and Kalidasa excels in it, I feel. Vachane eka dvi bahu vachana rupe. If we talk about one person in the as the Upameya, and I am talking about many people in the Upamana, then there is no auchityam there. So vachane api auchityam. Visheshane, this is very important. In fact, visheshanishta guna bodhaka pade. The visheshya is that which is being qualified. For example, Rama. and I am giving him a visheshana, Sundaraha. If I say Sundaraha Ramaha Ravanam Prati Yudhyati, is that an appropriate visheshana there? I don't need to know his beauty in the battlefield. So that visheshana of Sundaratvam, Lavanya Rupam and all that is unnecessary, or in fact it does not evoke the Veera Rasa there. It will in fact only look at him as, you know, Shringara Rasa Purvaka, but in the battlefield we don't want that. You should say Vyudo Raskaha might be more appropriate at that point of time. So Visheshana Auchityam, Upasarga Auchityam, Kriya Yoga Ashrite Pra Paradi Rupe. Upasargas are 22 in number. Pra, para, apa, ava, dur, dus, nir, you might have known all that. Which one you are using also matters in the Kriya. Nirgachati, nirvritihi, there are many slight differences. Upasarga yoge, dhatur artham, anyatra niyate. So the meaning itself goes somewhere. So you have to be very careful in using the upasarga. That auchityam is also necessary there. You can't randomly say, you know, prakarshati or pramodaha. Why pra? Pra means prakarshena. Whether it does intensify or is that intensification necessary in that shloka, in that word, you need to look at it. There is an auchitya there also. Nipate. Adravyarthakeyetu hi chadi rupe. Nipata is very, very important. Maybe in stotras or sahasranama and all that, you will find cha, hi, tu, vai, ha. All these words don't carry much of an importance because it is like vrittapurnam maybe. But in kavyam, it bears extreme importance. Even one api will change the whole color of the shloka. In Uttaramacharitam, என்ன இல்ல உத்தரம் சரித்தம் இல்ல சாகுந்தலம், இன் சாகுந்தலம் ந சும்பிதம் தூன்னு வரும். என்ன முகுரங்குளி சம்பிரதாதரோஷ்டாத்து துஷ்யந்தா இஸ் ட்ரைங் டு மேக் சகுந்தலா, யூ நோ, டாக் டு ஹர். ஹீ இஸ் வூயிங் ஹர் ஆக்சுவலி, அண்ட் ஹீ வாண்ட்ஸ் டு அப்ரோச் ஹர் அண்ட் கிஸ் ஹர். அட் தட் பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் டைம் ஹீ சேஸ், ஐ ஹவ் பீன் சிட்டிங் ஃப்ரம் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் டு ஈவினிங் ட்ரைங் டு கெட் க்ளோஸ் டு ஹர். ஷீ கீப்ஸ் டர்னிங் ஹர் ஃபேஸ், ஷீ கீப்ஸ், யூ நோ, ஹர் ஹேண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் ஆல்வேஸ் ஆன் ஹர் மவுத், அண்ட் இட்ஸ் வெரி டிஃபிகல்ட். ந சும்பிதம் து கதமபி உன்னமிதம் ந சும்பிதம் து. ஐ ட்ரைட் மை லெவல் பெஸ்ட் டு, யூ நோ, லிஃப்ட் ஹர். ஐ சம்ஹவ் லிஃப்டட் ஹர் ஃபேஸ், பட் ந சும்பிதம், சும்பன கிரியா து ந கிருதா. ந சும்பிதம் து, ஹி யூசஸ் தட் து தேர், பட் ஐ டிட் நாட், யூ நோ, த ஃபோர்ஸ் ஆஃப் டிசப்பாயின்ட்மெண்ட் தட் ஹி கன்வேஸ் வித் தட் து, ஒன்லி இஃப் யூ ரீட் தி என்டையர் தேர்ட் ஆக்ட், வென் யூ கம் டு தட் ஸ்லோகா, கதமப்பியுன்னமிதம் ந சும்பிதம் து, த டிசப்பாயின்ட்மெண்ட் வில் பி சீன் தேர். பிகாஸ் த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஷி வில் சே ரஜினி ஆகதா, தி ஈவினிங் டைம் ஹேஸ் கம். ஸோ ஹி ஸ்டார்டட் ஆஃப் வென் இட் வாஸ் ரியலி, யூனோ, இன் த ஆஃப்டர்நூன் டைம் வென் த சன் வாஸ் பிரைட் அண்ட் ஹெவி, அண்ட் தென் பை த டைம் ஹி செட் தி ஸ்லோகா, இட் வாஸ் ஆல்மோஸ்ட் ஈவினிங் டைம் அண்ட் த சந்தியா டைம் ஹட் கம். So the amount of disappointment that he faced will be shown with that tu. So you should never say chavai tuhi, and just it is for Padapuranam. That is not the case in Kavyam. At least it should not be the case with the kavi. Right? These are all Vyakarana. Next is your Lokatantra. What is the usual, you know, the life, how it is in the world, it is based on that. So kale samaye, you look at the samayam and talk about, you can't talk of love during the you know, time should be proper there. In a battlefield, if you look at Venisamharam, in the battlefield, the whole idea is that the battlefield is going to start. And before that, if you find Duryodhana having a Shringara with the Bhanumati, his wife, it is inappropriate. The time is not correct there. So that is the Kala Auchityam is not there. Desha, sthana vishesham. Again, the area should be proper for that and conducive for that. That is why you talk about the Uddipana Vibhava as adina sayankale vanante kusumita samaye chandrikayam saikate chandrikayam. That is very important, right? Amuranguli samvritadharoshtat pratishedha akshara viklavam viklavabhiramam. Mukham amsa vivarti pakshmanakshyaha kathamapi unnamitam nachambitam tu. Yeah, that is the full shloka. Okay. Next is desha, and then kula is vamsham. Vamsha is depends on how the whole thing is. For example, if you take Mrichakatikam, the vamsha in which he was born is a Brahmana vamsha. The Nayaka is Charudatta, who is a Brahmin. You can't have him as a Dhirodatta Nayaka. Dhirodatta is a person who is like a Kshatriya. So you can't, he has to perform only actions which are appropriate to his kula. That is kula auchityam. You cannot have Charudatta putting on an armor and fighting in the battlefield to show off Veera Rasam. He cannot do that. Nor in the way he approaches Vasantasena, you cannot have him approach with a courage, very forthright and forward, like how Dushyanta is. If you compare the characters of Dushyanta and Charudatta, be very different the way they approach in Shringara also. That is the kula auchityam. Whatever is the kula dharma, you have to portray the character as following that kula dharma also. Next is vratam niyama vishesha. There is also an auchityam in that. Whatever is the niyama that is being followed in the world, loka anu lokayattam, that should be followed in the kavyam also. If you look at the Natya Shastra, where he says loka vrittanukarana, that is your vratam, kula, desha, kala, and everything is that. Tatve, this is from here you have the kavi. For kavi, in fact, at the end he says, this is not comprehensive. Yes, Kamakshi?
Actually, na niyama visheshai konjam purila. So, like, if human, நம்மளுக்கு என்னெல்லாம் லிமிடேஷன்ஸ் இருக்கோ அதெல்லாம் அந்த பாத்திரங்களுக்கும் ஹியூமன் பாத்திரங்களுக்கு இருக்கணும்னு சொல்லணுமா இப்போ?
Yes.
Okay.
Cannot have, you know, because I have imagined something like Charudatan Vandu, ipo in Mrichakatika, I can't have Charudatan Vandu oru inda vratam eduthukuran, you know, and adu per enna, and champula vandudema, what is that, thirumbi yuddhathil irundhu thirumbi varada oru vratam onnu eduthundale inda asuralla, you know, there is a vrata that they tapatapurvakama onnu. They say they will not return from the battlefield. There is a vratam that they took, right? In Nilakanta Champu, there was one specific word that he used. You can't have Charudattan do that. So it should be lokanu, loka swabhava anukarana. So whatever you find in the world, that is the auchityam that he is talking about even in the beginning, right?
This equals, includes babasha, vesham, yellam.
Yes. If you see, I will take Mrichakatikam as the example for that. If you look at the, because we are not experts in the Prakritam that is there, the different types of Prakritam he uses itself is Desha Auchityam, Kula Auchityam, Vrata Auchityam. Everything falls there. He will use Maghadi for certain people, Shaurasaini for certain people.
Right.
Whereas Kalidasa will follow only one type of Prakritam in his. He has no issues about all that because Mrichakatika is a drama of the street and he is portraying different characters there. Each character comes from different places and they come to that gambling house and play. So in order to portray that difference, he uses that difference in Prakritam. Adha vandu, it is that Kala, Desha, Niyama, Kula. Adhula thane varudhu namakku. Anala it is imperative even in Natya Shastram. Bharata insists on loka swabhava anukarana. Loka swabhavajam. Siddham natyam loka swabhavajam. So you cannot go beyond unless you state that it is science fiction and it has nothing to do with the world. Even that world, if you look at Star Wars or Star Trek or anything, it will follow many things similar to that. Why do they have a captain? Because it follows what is there in the world. Even imagination follows certain base rules that are there in the world. Adida. That is your Lokatantra Sthitam Auchitya. Yeah. Next is Kavi. Kavi Gatam, he enumerates about 10 here, but that is not enough. And he, in fact, says at the end that this is beyond these 10. Now, whatever you can think about, everything will come there. So, Tattva, Tattva Abhidane or Yatharthya Kathane, Satya Upasthapane, Yatharthya Kathane, what is the Satyam? In, I don't know how much of Satyam can be involved in that. There should be an outline if you are, if it is not an itivrittam, if it is an itivrittam means what has happened before and you are taking that kathavastu. Or if it is a swayam, if it is his own pratibha, then he depends on his pratibha for that auchitya. He does not need to depend on the satyam for it. Okay, this tattva is based on the tattvam that is found in the Puranas or Ramayana or Mahabharata or any reality that has happened, like Shivaji. If you take Shivaraja Champu, there is one Gadyam where he talks about Shivaji's rule. There is a Gadya. That will be based on Tattvam. It will be based on Tattvam. There can be embellishments on it. There is a Tyagaraja Charitam where someone has written an entire Kavyam on Tyagaraja. One, actually, there are two Kavyams on Tyagaraja, where one has been written by Harikeshan Allur Muthiyavagadar, the other has been written by T.S. Sadashiva. And that Sadashiva, what he has written, has more exaggerations. It has a very thin line of Tattva, and he relies more on his pratibha, whereas in Harikeshan Allur's, it will be more to the point and more in keeping with the work of or the life of Tyagaraja. So these are not everything need not be present as far as the kavi goes. It depends. You have to take it case by case. Sattve antarbala abhikyapane. I think it is more to do with how the yes, how actually?
இது எல்லாமே only for காவ்யா இல்ல இதிகாச
Not it. This is
இருக்கும்
only for Kavya Auchityam. Because Kavya Jivatu Bhutam Auchityam, அப்படின்னு சொல்றாரு. It won't be for Itihasa. Because on the Itihasatla வந்து, it is a wider playground and it will not come under this. For you, Kavyam is more of a constricted and on the you're bound by certain rules in a Kavyam, so you can bring about Auchityam and everything. Yeah. Sattvengarathu antarbala abhikyapane. Antarbala abhikyapane is what is the strength of the Kavi. You look at Bharavi for that. Vishesha Audharya Visheshashalinim Vacham. It is Artha Gauravam is the greatness of Bharavi. That is his own greatness, which he has shown through his poetry. Right? You, more than anything, you, the first thing that strikes when you read his poetry is the greatness of the Kavi itself. So he also reveals his greatness through his poetry. That is, even while doing that, it should be uchitam. That's why I took the example of Bharavi. He starts off with a Vanechara who talks to Yudhishthira, talking about the rule of Duryodhana. So when the Vanechara, as an introduction to the Vanechara's ukti, he says, sa saushtava audharya visheshashalinim vinischitartham iti vachamadade. Sa saushtava audharya, sushtoho bhavaha saushtava. Udarasya bhavaha audaryam, saushtava audarya visheshashalini. The words are so beautiful and prakasha with saushtava audarya, etc. So in result, he is saying the Vanechara spoke these words with a propriety and it was shining with greatness. What does he mean? It's his veiled pride that he says that my words are like that. No? Even when saying that his words are like that, he uses auchityam. He does not generally open up with an introduction saying, you know, I am writing this kavyam and it is beautiful. That's not what he was trying to say. So he wanted to get the point that his words are also extremely, you know, beautiful and appropriate through portraying the words of Vanechar. Adhu avarude greatness. Huh? So that is his antarbala abhikyapane. Even while saying his antarbala or his greatness, there should be an auchityam there. Abhipraye tatparye. In revealing what tatparyam is, vaktru vivaksha, what the vakta wishes to convey, what the person who wants to convey conveys it in an appropriate manner. Swabhave is nisarge. This is probably about riti, where the style of the poet comes out in a very natural manner, and there is, if the subject matter also requires that type of a style and he uses that style. I am only guessing. These are all, you know, he gives udaharanam of where the swabhava auchitya is there and swabhava anauchityam is there, and everything has an example behind. We won't be reading all these. We will stop with rasa. Maybe if we have time, we can go further also. Sara sangrahe nishkrishta artha katane. Summary. If you look at what is that? Prakritya mitabhashinaha in Shishupala Vadam, second sarga, the Buddhava, Balrama, and Krishna are all three of them are talking there. And first, Krishna starts off saying, you know, I have a dilemma. This Shishupala is constantly creating trouble for us. I have to go and fight him. At the same time, I'm also faced with a problem that I will pardon his mistakes. Now, he is going to come to Rajasuya Yagam, and I am sure he will insult me there, and there will come a time where I'll have to kill him. Now, tell me, what do I do? Shall I go kill him now itself, or wait till Rajasuya Yaga, wait till all the insults are happened, and then kill him there? So, I need your advice. Krishna asks the advice of Uddhava and Balrama. If you see, he will talk very shortly, and Balrama, in fact, will say, Prakritya mitabhashinaha. People like you are by nature mitam. They talk in measured words. Mine is just sutrasya eva megati, bhashyasya eva megatihi. Mine is just like a bhashyam for your sutra praya words. So the summary with which he gives the dilemma in just for 5 or 6 shlokas, that's all Krishna will speak in that entire sargam of some 150 shlokas. He will just speak for 8 shlokas. The rest will all be Balrama and Uddhava. So that will be the Nishkrishna Artha Katane. Very sweet, short and sweet, and he will portray it very beautifully. He is also capable of writing huge descriptions. In 6th Sarka, he will just describe the Raivataka Parvata in a great manner. That also he is capable. At the same time, if he has to convey something in a very short manner, he can do that too. That is a Kavi's greatness. Sara Sangrahe Pratibhayam. Pratibha is creativity. That is described, the Lakshana of Pratibha is Nava Nava Unmesha Shalini Pratibha Buddhihi. Nava Nava Unmesha. It just opens up fresh ideas at every point. The entire episode of Durvasa's Shapa is a creation of Kalidasa. It is his Pratibha Vishesha. In Padma Purana, Dushyanta is portrayed as a person who forgets Shakuntala and later accepts her because the child is his. There are several rishis who come and say that this person is going to rule and the Bharata Varsha will be named after him and all that. Then he gets convinced and accepts it. But to make Dushyanta as the epitome of virtue was in the hands of Kalidasa and his Pratibha. That is Namanama Unmesha Shalini. Even while portraying, because it had to suit his Kavya Vastu, he created that incident to give flesh to that Dhirodhatta Nayaka. Avasthayam vayah prakrame, vayah krame, in the sense, I don't know what he actually means by this. Maybe the age appropriate actions that are being portrayed in the Kavyam could be something which is there in the hands of the poet more than the Lokatantra. See, people you will find even at the age of 40 and 50 finding love. That's fine. That works in the world. But in a Kavyam for us to enjoy, I don't know how much it will gel. In a being in Sanskrita world and in this literature world I'm talking about, it is a very small world that we are talking about. Maybe further in ages or when centuries down the lane, we might have people writing Kavyam in different aspects. It could be there. But today, the gamut of literature world is such that you will find the Nayaka and the Nayika in a very, let's say, young age. The only place where I find that old love, which is beautiful, is Mahim Mooladhare Kamapi Manipure Hutavaham Stitham Swadhishtane Hridi Maratam Akasham Upari Manopi Bhrumadde Sakalamapi Vitva Kulapatham Sahasrare Padme Saharahasi Pritya Vihari. He doesn't mention who that is. The Shiva and Parvati are constantly there in that Sahasrara Padma. And Sahasrare Padme Saharahasi Patya Viharasi. She beautifully and secretly, she is in that Sahasrara Padma with her Pati, with Shiva. Purana Purusha. But the way we describe him is also Sada Yabbanaha. So I don't know how this will work in Auchityam. Anyway, so Avasthayam. Next is Vichare Vivechanayam. Analysis. The way a character is analyzing, or the way the poet analyzes the character, there should be an auchityam even there. Namni, this is my favorite. Namni is in Uttaramacharitam, Mastu Virahaha. Rama sits with Sita and he says, I should never be separated from Sita. That moment, Deva Upasthitaha. A pratihari, a doorkeeper comes and says, Deva Upasthitaha, it is here, which means it is as if it is indicating for a moment, there will be a jerk in your mind and you feel, my God, virahaha mastu. Immediately if he says it is here, oh, that means they are going to be separated. And the person who comes to convey that bad news that the world is talking in very anauchitya manner about Sita, the character's name there is Durmukha. He has a bad face. So Durmukha, or one who talks in a very bad manner. The name of that character is Durmukha. That is the Nama Auchitya. Beautiful section that part is. Namni Namadheye. Ashishi Ashirvachane. Even an Ashirvada Vachanam, that is either in the Mangala Shloka or in the Bharata Vakyam, there should be an Auchityam. This is our Tremendra's example of Paramauchitya Karine. There the Kavya Vastu is portrayed there. Some people even write something which is completely not at all connected. But in Ratnavali, if you find, the shlokam itself conveys the different bhavas that both Udayana and Ratnavali will go through in the entire natakam. That will be beautifully explained in one of the Mangala shlokams. So the Ashirvachana shlokam and the Bharata Vakyam. Mama Vichak Shabayati Neela Lojanaha, I think Shakuntalatla, the last verse is also, you know, should be appropriate the way he ends the Kavyam also. So Edeshu Pada Prabhritishu Sthaneshu Marmasu Iva Kavyasya Sakala Sharira Vyapi Jivitam Auchityam Sputatvena Spuratu Avabhasati. So Edeshu Pada Prabhritishu Sthaneshu, in all these Pada etc. Marmasu, these are all the different internal organs also. It is like the internal organs that are there in the Kavya, both the outer and the inner vital organs of a Sharira. The same way, these are all like the vital parts of a Kavya Sharira. So, Sakala Sharira Vyapi Yatu Jivitam Bhutam Tatu Auchityam Eva Atra. So, Auchityam becomes very important, and Sputatvena Spuratu Avabhasati. It is very clear and very apparent if one word is off key. That we will know from the example. The first example we see is for Pada Auchityam. So before he starts with the Udaharanam, he gives a definition for the Pada Auchityam. Tilakam Bibrati Suktihi Bhatyekam Uchitam Padam Chandrananeva Kasturi Kritam Shyama Iva Chandanam. Tilakam Bibrati Suktihi Suktihi, something which is Suktihi Bhati. A nice expression is beautiful, or bhati, it vilangugiradungiradha na eppadi English la solluven,
prakashate iti va,
prakashate, yes, that's what I can say, but prakashate is too much, I feel. So it just okay,
shiny. Shines it, yeah, bhati.
I know bhati means shines. Let's just take it like that. Okay. Prakashate itteva odeva. Kasturi kritam tilakam viprati chandranana iva. Now you have two different types of women, who one is very fair, the other is very dark, shyama. One is chandranana. Her face is like the moon, so she is fair. The other is dark. The both of them are wearing a tilakam. Tilakam bibhati. Both of them are wearing a tilakam. How is the tilakam? Now the Chandranana, one who is very fair, if she wears a tilakam with chandanam, then it will not show at all. She's so fair that tilakam with chandanam will not enhance the beauty of her face. So she has to use something called kasturi. Kasturi is mrigamada. It is a black kind of, or a brownish kind of thing, tilakam, with which you put a tilakam, bindi. So that kasturi kritam tilakam chandranana bibhrati iva, yatha chandranana bibhrati tatha, or shyama, if she is a dark complexioned lady, if she wears a chandana tilakam, then it looks beautiful. If she wears a dark colored tilaka, then it is not going to add a beauty, nor is it uchitam. It's not blending, it's blending too much with the face that it is not showing her in a different light. It's what he says here. So chandanam tilakam yatha shyama vibrati tatha ekam padam uchitam padam chet suktihi bhati. If there is just one padam, one word which is appropriate there, then the entire shloka will have a beauty to it, will be beautiful because of that just one padam. Let's see an example. He gives both an example and a counter example. So pada uchityasya udaharanam magnani dvishatam kulani samare tvatkhadga dhara kule नाथास्मिन्निति वन्दिवाचि बहुशो देवश्रुतायां पुरा मुग्धा गुर्जर भूमिपाल महिषि प्रत्याशया पाथसः कांतारे चकिता विमुञ्चति मुहुः पत्युः कृपाणे दृशौ. The idea here is, one king has won over the गुर्जर भूमिपाल. गुजरात, गुर्जर इज गुजरात. गुजरात किंग हैज बीन वन ओवर बाय सम अदर किंग. Now that king is in the darbar, and Vandi Jana. Vandi is a person who is praising the king. So he comes there, and he is a kavi. Not Vandi, he is a kavi. A kavi is coming and praising the victor king, the one who has won. When he is talking about his victory over the Gurjara Bhumipala, he talks about the Mahishi, or the wife of that king, that Gujarat king. He says, you know, that wife is such a mugdha, innocent, or she doesn't know anything. So what does she say? She has heard, they're all in the forest now. Okay, Kantare, Chakita, Mugdha, Gurjara, Bhumipala, Mahishi. So she is very afraid, and she is in the Kantara, in the forest. So the moment this king won over the Gujarat king was banished to the forest, and he is staying in the forest. Okay. Now this lady, the wife, the queen, has heard the Stuti Pataka many times saying that, you know, this king, oh king, you have won over so many other kings and you have destroyed enemy families with your khadga, with your sword. So they keep praising the king, and it is their natural thing to praise the king. So this girl has heard, or this queen has heard this so many times. And what are the words that she has used? They use there, Dvishatam kulani magnani. Dvishatam shatrunam kulani magnani. They have been, they have all been submerged in what? Tvat khadga dhara akule samare. Khadga dhara, dhara has two meanings. One is khadga dhara is the sharp edge of the sword, is called khadga dhara. Tvat khadga dhara, tava khadga dhara akule vyapte asmin samare yudhe. In this battlefield, which is filled with the sharpness of your sword. In this battlefield, Dvishatam kulani magnani, he uses a pun, or he uses double meaning for the word dhara, and says in this flow of your sword, the families of the Shatru have all submerged, magnani. They have drowned in the dhara of your khadga, of your sword. So what he means is, what the Vandi or the Vandivachi, iti Vandivachi satyam. When such words of the Stuti Pataka were there, what were they saying? They were saying that you used your sword and killed many enemies in the battlefield. But the words that they used were, Thvat kadga dhara akule samare dvishatam kulani magnani. The word dhara is the problem here. So this girl, she understood that dhara as water flow. So she says, Mugdha Gurjara Bhumipala Mahishi. Okay, wait. Iti Vandi Vachi Pura before Bahushaha Shrutayam Satyam. Hey Deva, this Hey Deva is for the king who is one and who is in the darbar listening to the Kavi who is talking. Okay, so Hey Deva, Sa Mugdha Pura before, she has heard Bahushaha Shrutayam Bhuyaha Shruta. What did she listen to? Vandi Vachaha. She has listened so many times to the Stuti Pataka's words that this king had killed so many people. Instead of that, she had heard Khadga Dhara Kule Samare. And what did she think? Mugdha Gurjara Bhumipala Mahishi Pathasaha Pratyashaya. She wanted water. She's so thirsty. So pathasaha jalasya pratyashaya ashaya tava khadgam punah punaha pashyati. She keeps looking at your not tava khadgam, patyuhu khadgam. So patyuhu kripane on the sword drishav vimunchati. She keeps looking at the sword for water continuously, because she heard the words that khadga dharakule samare natha Dvishatam kulani magnani also. See, the words he uses, everything will fit. How will it fit? Only because of that one word, Mugdha. If she had said Sundari Gurjara Bhumipala Mahishi, then it will not fit. Tanvi. Tanvi will also fit with the meter. Tanvi Gurjara Bhumipala Mahishi. It will fit, but this idea that she keeps looking at her husband's sword for water will not even fit. It will only fit if she is portrayed as a mudha or a fool who does not understand the different meanings of dhara and magnam and all that. If she doesn't understand the portrayal of what the Stuti Pataka are trying to say. That is your auchityam here. So the mugdha padena, atra mugdha padena auchitya chamatkarina suktihi. Because there is an auchityam here, the sukti or the sahityam, the kavyam has a chamatkari because of the auchityam of the word mugdha. Sharadindu vadana iva. This is actually lakshana samanvayam. You know, the lakshana that he gives for pada auchityam is just like how in a tilakam for a Shyamatilaka, for a Sharadindu Vadana is beautiful the same way. So Sharadindu Vadana either for a lady who is fair faced, a Shyamatilakam, a black Tilakam is very beautiful, and the same way Shyama Shubhra Visheshakena, if she has a Shubhra Visheshakam is like the white thing either with Chandanam or like, you know, Sri Churnam, which you the Vaishnavas all use one white color thing for Namam. That is a Sri Churnam. Or with a white Sri Churnam, she can have a Tilakam. That also Vibhushita Sakala Kavikula Lalama Bhutam Vichittim Atanoti. The word Vichitti means beauty, Vichitrata, Vaichitriam. So Sakala Kavikula Lalama Bhuta. Lalama Bhuta is the crest jewel for the entire Kavi world. Is even one padam is enough to give a beauty to it. This more than the shloka, this is very useful because, see, for certain Kavis, we don't know what they wrote, when they wrote. So there are many recensions as far as manuscripts goes. If you find in a text, someone would have written underneath, this is a different word which has been substituted. So you, this pada auchityam and vakya auchityam is very important to fix a reading in a work or a manuscript. If you take Kumarasambhavam, there is an beautiful shloka in fifth sargam. You time patukre. I'll just finish with this. It'll take 5 minutes. Huh? For the pada auchityam in fifth sargam, see, Parvati is doing tapas, huh? And Shiva wants to test her. So Shiva comes there and he asks her pikriyartham, because he comes in the form of a brahmachari and keeps asking her, do you have everything that you need for your tapas? Is everything fine? Then he says, why are you doing this tapas? So the friend who is standing nearby says, you know, wants to become the wife of Shiva. Brahmachari, Shiva, who has come in the disguise of a brahmachari, he laughs at her and says, what is this stupid venture that you are on? You know, it is not at all appropriate for you. Imagine, you know, you will become an object of ridicule. Imagine how the Kalyana Utsavam will happen. You will be in a great mahakshaha. You will be on a chariot or with a horse or elephant. Elephant, you will be on an elephant, whereas he will come in a vriddhokshaha. Or kero nandi lokan or madila vrishabham. He will be sitting on an old cow. It's so incongruent. Now you will be wearing pattu vastram, the kshauma vastram, and he will be wearing gaja charma, which will be dripping with blood. These are the difference in both of their states. So he will say, Mahajana smeramukha bhavishyati. Great people will look at this couple and they will say, there is no ausityam in the two of them, and they will laugh at you. Says, Dvayam gatam samprati shochaniyatam samagama prarthanaya kapalinaha kalachasa kantimati kalavati tvamasya netrasya tvamasya lokasya cha netra kaumudi. Two people will attain a pitiable state here. They will be fit to be pitied. One who is already, you know, kalachasa kantimati kalavataha, kalavataha chandrasya kantimati kala. Kala is that one digit of that crescent moon that is there, is actually in Strilingam here. And he says, kalavataha kalavati kala, it is already shochaniyatam dasham gata. Why? Because she has gone and sat, she wanted to be with Shiva. And that Chandra Kala is there in Shiva. So it is already in one pitiable state. Samprati dvayam gatam. Now two people have to be pitied now. Why? Tvamcha asya lokasya netra kaumudi. You are like the moonlight for this entire world. And you also have to be pitied. Here the auchityam lies in that one word, kapalina. He himself is a kapali. He has that, you know, kapalam. Kapalam is your mandavoda. That is, he plucks Brahma's fifth head and has that at his, as his bhikshapatra. He himself is a person who is going from house to house for bhiksha, and you both want to be with him. Dvayam gatam samprati shochaniyata. What are you asking for him? Samagama prarthanaya. You want to be with him. Such a person who is a kapali. There is another reading here called Pinaki. So Pinaki naha, both the meter will be fine. Dvayam gatam samprati shochaniyata samagama prarthanaya Pinaki naha will also be fine. But Pinaki is not the appropriate word. You know why? Because he has a Pinaka, the bow, which is Pinaka. He can win over the entire world with the Pinaka. So your dasha is not shochaniyata, it is actually varam. Whereas if he, see there are 1008 Shiva Sahasranamam, and you find there are 1008 names for Shiva. If you look at Rudram, the entire thing has so many names for Shiva, but Kalidasa chose to use Kapalinaha there. See, he already has a Bhiksha Patram in his hand. Why do you want to go and be with him? Mahajanas Meramukho Bhavishyati. Dvayam Gatam Sampra. That is the Pada Auchityam you have to look at. The Kapali is the word that even each and every, even for Pratyaya Auchityam, you can go for that. That Kalavataha. He has different kalas, but with just one kala that Chandra wants to go and associate himself with Shiva. Why does he use Netra Kaumudi instead of Parvati here? You are like, you know, the apple of the eye for the people, and you want to go. Which mom would want to send her daughter to such a person? Mata Rupam, Pita Vittam, Mata. Pita Kulam, Mata Kulam.
Kanya Varayate Rupam.
Adita Kanya Varayate Rupam. Mata Kulam, Pita Vittam.
Mata Vittam, Pita Shrutam.
Pita Shrutam. Whichever. Yedume Angelia. Rupam, the Rupam with which Shiva comes and stands in front of her, you will feel only afraid of it. Bayam da varo. Ingin Shringaram varo. Alam the Kapalina Mahajana Smeramukho Bhavishyati. This is the word is very important there. Okay, I'll stop this. Chariya. Is that okay? Kamakshi, any doubt?
Yes, actually. Iduko in the Parikarankura Alankaratko. Vityasamarka.
Okay. Parikarankura Alankaram. This pada auchityam contributes to it. You can say both are very similar. It is the same. But what he is not talking about the alankara as such here, ana the appropriateness of that word that you need. If you want to define it as alankara, well and good. Parikara ankura is a later alankaram which has been coined by Abhay Dikshitar.
Okay.
And he came in the 14th century. Yeah. 15th, 16th, though, something like that. He came much later than Kshemendra. By that time, this was not used as an alankara at all. So instead of saying it as an alankaram, the auchityam with which it is used, if it so contributes to the beauty of the artham and the words, then well and good. It is parikara alankaram because we are in the 21st century analyzing this shloka and we know that there exists an alankara and someone has done it. Yeah. Otherwise, it is that auchityam, the appropriateness with which it has been.
No, I actually maathi thondrathu. Yedhukku iva parikara ankuram nu onnu vechukkanum thondrathu.
Exactly. We will go back to Bharata where he says only the four alankaras are there. Upama, Rupakam, Drishtantam, avadi nodvare. Avladha. It is so much more beautiful to look at the auchityam than the alankaras.
And also இவரே வந்து அப்புறம் வந்து விசேஷன ஔச்சித்யம்னு ஒண்ணு தனியா சொல்றாரு இல்லையா அதுக்கும் இந்த எக்ஸாம்பிள் இருக்கிற முக்தாக்கும் ஓவர்லாப் இருக்கா
ஐ டோன்ட் நோ வி வில் see how that goes இல்லையா ஏன்னா விசேஷணம் கர்ச்சு வெதர் see குர்ஜர பூமிபால மகிஷி முக்தா அண்ட் இஃப் யூ ஐ திங்க் தி இன் ஸ்வப்னவாசவதத்தம் தேர் இஸ் அ ஸ்லோகா வேர் ஹி கிவ்ஸ் அ செட் ஆஃப் ஐ வில் லுக் இட் அப் அண்ட் டெல் யூ நெக்ஸ்ட் டைம் where there is a set of visheshanas he gives for Padmavati. Adhile vandu unakku vandu each set describes, each visheshana describes Padmavati in such a manner that she is such a great personality and so you can approach her. Avladanga. So that is your visheshana auchityam. You can't just simply put some Rajakumari or something in an ashrama when you are describing Padmavati. The Rajakumari will not be a good visheshana. Whereas someone who is Kula Abhimani would be better. Anna, or someone who has a good gunam, then it will be appropriate. And the shlokam eduthu kudutha dhaan seriya irukum. Illana you won't understand that visheshana auchitya. And this. I will look up that and tell you next time about the difference between Pada Auchityam and Visheshana Auchityam.
Okay.
Okay. We'll stop with this. Namaste.